are very honored to have, where is our Imam Hassan Khan? Imam Hassan Khan, oh, we are honored that we have a visiting Imam from England right now. He is a polyglot, he speaks several languages, including our local, and he speaks English. So, connects with the youth and adults alike. He will share his pearls of wisdom about Ramadan. So please.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. May the mercy of God be upon you all, and may his peace and blessings be upon all of his prophets, Jesus, Abraham, Ishmael, Moses, and our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon them all. I don't usually prepare speeches like this. I'm more of a off-the-cuff type of guy, you know, whatever comes out, it just comes out. But I've spent a bit of time preparing something, so I'll read something. It's more of a reflection for myself personally. About the month of Ramadan and what it means to us. So God informs the people of faith in his divine revealed scripture, that is the Quran, the purpose behind fasting in the August month of Ramadan. God says, O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed upon you just as it has been prescribed upon those before you, so that you may attain God consciousness, so that you may attain God consciousness of Allah. Various previous dispensations and classical religious traditions have experienced the act of fasting and the spiritual openings and pleasures that they gain from it. The month of Ramadan is a yearly school to which Muslims return and recharge their batteries and realign their wavering compasses of certainty, piety, faith and gratitude towards the divine once more. It allows to break from the chains of modernity and reconnects us back to nature and the cosmos itself. And in fact, Muslims, to determine the month of Ramadan, look towards the sky. And I think that's an important message for us all, to relieve ourselves from the chains of modernity, to make sure that we are connecting back to nature once more. And we look towards the moon, towards determining the new month of Ramadan. And as, outside of the month, we fail to recognize and take heed of our natural disposition. Yet, as soon as the month comes back into our lives, we find a deeper connection to our true nature. Why is that? Well, because our thoughts are not playing gymnastics with us in preparation for our next meal or snack. Rather, we are more focused on the natural world and become distant from distractions which help us to normally observe. As such, we experience that our personal vices come less easily. For example, gluttony and lust are the most obvious iniquities that we can sedate and abolish. This allows us the spiritual sight to become sharper and view our surroundings with a more discerning, piercing and faithful glance. Similarly, we feel more reluctant to speak ill of others, backbite and to use vulgar language, ensuring that there is no breach of an inward courtesy to the divine. And therefore, we can maintain our quasi-angelic state of the fast. Finally, one of the paramount lessons of the month of Ramadan that we attain is humility. Not just a sense of humility, but to rather implement it and feel the delights of humility. So modesty is the true nature of everything and the very fiber of the believer. Pride is the worst of the deadly sins, because pride can never be gathered and God-fearingness will never be as a result, meaning that pride can never coexist with a believer, because that would prevent him from having fear of God. Aside from this, during the month you have feelings of pride in something you have done or possess, then know that you are competing with the divine, who is the greatest. So the shrinking of our pompous selves in Ramadan is precisely about the enlarging and liberation of the spirit in tasting the delights of our obedience to God Almighty. Thank you.
Thank you, Imam Hassan.